So it's 2022, and we're here to start the new year off with a bang. One thing I think in 2022 we need to work on is self-defense. One thing about him is look at where his hands are always low, so it's like it's easy to hit his face. Yeah, it's always something. It's like this guy right here.
Oh shit, really?
Here's the problem is Dom's gotta set himself up for it.
No. Look,
put your hands up. Put your hands up like you're doing self-defense.
It's gonna be a realistic situation. Look, I need you to throw up this speed, right? Throw it at that speed. Throw it at that speed, ready?
I will go like that.
Just like that. If somebody throws a punch at me, I'm gonna catch it every time.
You keep your hands up. Okay? And the first thing you do when someone attacks you,
yeah,
is you pull out your phone and you call 911. I don't expect you to hold yourself up in a bar fight. I don't see you wrestling a pig. I see a tortoise coming up to you and scaring you.
Yeah.
You just don't seem like a guy that can handle adversity.
You put your hands up, and then you pull out the glizzy. Just like that.
Get this guy out of here. I'll see you at the gym. Get out of here.
Let's go to the gym.
I'm done. Do something. Work on your shoulders. Hey, Ant. You see Ant's shoulders? You see this? How they crevice down like the slopes of K1, the mountain? One of the tallest slopes in the world. You see this? You're like a 2x4, right? This is like a shelf. Like, I want to put a flower here. Let's cut this up a little bit this year.
Let's go to the gym.
Cold in here.
What, to get him? Nobody's going to sit here like this with a gun, though. I'd have shot Tori.
Yeah,
you really
that's the point, you didn't shoot me.
My God. Hey, just keep your shirt on today, bro.
Keep a jacket on because it's cold as shit, whatever he's hanging from his earlobe right now.
Because this fool is the most shredded dude on the planet.
Don't believe that.
And I see you brushing your teeth on your story every morning with your shirt off, and I'm like, dude, what the fuck is this guy on? Nah, you're gonna take your fucking shirt off because this guy's, dude.
We're gonna have to show him the credentials.
Yeah.
What kind of chest credit?
It's Olympia
shit.
Style.
Oh, shit.
Maybe like 27? All right, so one of the reasons why I like to start with this exercise is because at the cable machine, you can replicate the same kind of tension, the same kind of squeeze over and over and over again. Whereas with something like maybe a compound movement, you gotta focus a little bit more on holding it stable. These machines are a little bit different.
It's a good thing to start with. You get that stretch. It's not like you're compound and you're staying all tight. You gotta start out with a little get loose, you know?
Facts. I agree with that. I agree with that 100%. You definitely should start out with something that's gonna pump some blood, stretch you out. But me personally, I'm a fan of compound movements.
Oh!
And you know why that is, I feel like?
Because you're built like a 2x4?
Yes. Yes. No, because honestly, both of you guys are bodybuilders. Competitive bodybuilders. You're an IFBB pro, you are too.
Yeah.
And these are the exercises, like compound movements. Am I right or am I wrong? I don't fucking know. I've never competed before, so I'm asking these two. IFBB pro, Olympian, right here too. So I'm asking you guys, are compound movements important for bodybuilders, like that want to do like competitions and shit? Because you don't really see too much of it, I feel like, nowadays.
I say it's important, super important.
Because back then, back in the day, I feel like you saw like a bunch of people squatting and shit like that. Nowadays, you don't really see a lot of
honestly, a lot of my preps, I did a lot of isolation exercises, a lot of single arm, one-sided stuff.
So not too much compound.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I did a lot. Actually, I did a mixture. I usually warmed up with cables and isolation most of the time, just to put blood in the muscle, and then I went hard as shit with my compounds. But I never really felt prepared to go hard as shit until I warmed up adequately with something like a cable machine or something like that.
Is there a reason?
Why?
Because like just like through sports and stuff, and we all played sports, and you guys remember during sports and stuff, it was always like compound movement. And I know that's what you train for. Like you're training to be more explosive. Bodybuilding, you're training to be more sculpted and
proportioned.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But like, is there a reason why you guys did away with that? Is it because of like maybe injury and stuff, or like?
I still love.
Because I can't go without doing compound movements.
But I will say, I think a lot of competitors and bodybuilder-esque type of like training styles, people that train that way, I feel like a lot of people like punk out from compound movements. People like are afraid of like ass to grass squats. People are afraid of like, you know, barbell presses and shit. So, yeah.
And I really do feel like the difference in your physique when you do incorporate those is night and day.
Hell yeah.
You can tell the people that are doing those compound movements, heavyweight squats, compared to heavyweight leg press. You can tell the difference in physique. for sure. Real. 100%.
Oh, we went to 70 pounds.
Like between like 10 to 15.
10 to 15?
Yeah, nice and warm.
10 to 15. So that when you have your chain on, it just sits like this, you
know? Nice and high.
Hide the chain.
Big wide stretch.
Let's see.
Guys, we're letting Ant run us through this chest workout. Because if you've ever seen this guy's chest, we'll have Wayne pip up a picture of him. He's got a pretty serious one.
Tell
so
him,
with
Joe.
That being said, we're going to go hit some barbell incline bench press. Let go. So we decided to just go ahead and take this a little challenge. We're warming up right now. This is the last warm-up set, 185. And then we're going to throw 225 on there, which is 245s on each side. And we're going to rep it out for six. The first person, and we're just going to keep doing sets of that. The first person to tap out that can't get six on their own, you're out. Who's going to be the last one standing? Comment below.
I play for keeps. I want to go on record. I don't fucking play.
No longer Joey Smokes.
Joe Poppy Seed Andrews.
I'm Joey Sharktooth. Because I got a shark tooth necklace.
I've trained the same.
You've got a lot of separation.
I've trained the same my whole life. Even like even during contest prep, train the same. Train the same as I trained today.
Take your form and just flex.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But there are people who train way different in contest prep. They just like flip their whole training style. So I just train exactly the same.
Pretty sure I'm gonna get this one.
Oh
yeah.
Oh yep. Shit.
Just ruined it.
Oh shit.
Hey Wayne, put this song for this competition.
Calling a young nigga fall. Where's Ali with the motherfucking dog?
Bitch,
I be ballin' like a motherfucking pro.
I thought we were doing chess.
What the fuck is he?
This is
you can't
this
take guy this guy
does.
Nowhere.
Excuse. We'll come over with some excuse. Our shoulders are too pumped to bench.
We're doing chess.
Oh, what's up, man?
Put your shirt back on.
Oh, put your shirt.
I'm right.
Holy shit.
Wow. Look at his shoulders though.
That was fucking hard.
I don't know.
Holy shit, yeah. So you got three sets, right? That was three sets and five reps.
Yeah. Five, run through them like rip wall, baby.
Oh shit. Come on, you got five more. Five more.
What's this guy doing?
Do my chest.
Good, come on. Come on.
What?
Come on.
Three more.
Up.
Fuck. Right. Hey, you gotta get more than three reps to beat him, cause he's a set ahead of you.
I'm gonna get 10.
Hey, yeah, that's true. I haven't lost yet.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
I want you guys to count these.
As soon as you get past three reps.
This is the regulation. Another last step.
I think he's got two.
I need you guys to count these.
You count this. Yeah.
Okay. Ready?
Go ahead.
One.
Zero.
2.
0.
3.
0.
Yep. Nope. Nope. Nope.
God dang it.
Alright.
Guys, you got 2 more?
I'll take it from here, boys. All right, so we have a cable exercise, which open you up, get some blood flow going. We did the compound incline barbell, which is more compact.
Get that upper core, shelf going.
Upper shelf. Ant, where are you going next, bro?
I think we gotta even it out, maybe some flat machine.
Machine. So, okay, cable free press. Weight, machine.
What do you think, guys?
I like it. Let's go.
Oh, is that good with you, Delt Game?
Yeah. Okay, so why do you do that?
Well, naturally, I never really train like lower chest. My theory is most men, most of us, we have a lagging upper chest. We don't train it very often. So if you develop your upper chest, gravity will make it so you'll develop a lower. You'll have a lower chest by building your upper. Shit will just sit right. So what we're gonna do is we already hit some upper. We really hit some upper here. Now we're just gonna hit some flat machine right for the sides. Sound cool?
I'm down. As long as we can look like that chest that you saw earlier, I'm down. How many?
We'll put 2 plates on, or maybe even 3. We'll do 3.
You a fan of like warm-up sets for every exercise?
Just
even
one.
Though like you're like deep in.
Sometimes. And only if I'm changing the plane of motion, especially like. From going from like here to here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, I feel like regardless, like that's every day, every exercise. I could warm up with chest, right? And that's like your warm up for the day.
Mm-hmm.
But like when you go there to bench, to this, to the next one, I always have to hit a warm up set.
Transitional warm up set.
There's some people though that'll literally be like, dude, I'm warmed up. We're halfway through the workout.
And they'll jump into like 2 more plates on something else. And like,
not me.
I feel real sketch doing shit like that.
No, I feel you on that.
It takes like no effort to just make sure you're good.
Because you do, bro. You do have to readjust your muscles and your mind to this movement, this plane of motion.
Remind the muscle. Like, this is what I need you to do from now on.
Yeah,
you
know? Because this is completely different than this and this.
Firing way different fibers. So. Oh yeah.
Always do warm-up sets. Don't be afraid to do warm-up sets. I'm telling you guys, it is absolute key. To do a warm-up set, it makes sure you get your mind back to that muscle and the plane of motion that you're working with, because it's all different.
How many set?
How many are you doing?
Maybe just 1 more for him, maybe?
How many reps are you doing?
Oh, 10? 8, 10?
Yeah. Fuck, I've been doing 20 this whole time.
Bro.
Somebody could have told me.
I like this day. Shit. Today's a good day.
Like crashed,
chest day is always a good day, especially on Monday.
Like
you know what they say? Monday is International Chest Day. They're talking about something else. Fucking gas station
so
or something.
3, 4, 4.
You guys forgot to do that, huh?
Oh, fuck.
Big weight for Big Red. For Big Joey. Big Wayne. Big Damn.
So far, we've done a cable, a barbell, a machine, and a dumbbell. And honestly, when you get a complete workout using a variety of different equipment, that is the best workout right there. So we're gonna knock this out. We have about 10 to 12 reps on the incline dumbbell, and then that's gonna wrap the chest workout. So guys, I hope you learned something in this. I hope you learned something too.
Oh, I did. Ah.
All right, boys, so that is a wrap on the workout. Complete chest workout. We did a bunch of different exercises, and it was Ant Woods chest day. So
it was wild.
An Olympian chest day.
I hope this workout helps someone out there build a bigger chest. I know today I got better. Dom got better, he got better. If you guys have any questions, drop them down below. If not, I hope you guys like the video. Subscribe to the channel. Stay tuned for the next episode. Let's go.